Governor Malloy promised that education reform would be his top priority, and he has proposed some major changes for schools and for teachers. But the bill that passed this week doesn't look like the governor's, and some say teacher unions are trying to carve out their own deal. Joining us is Mary Loftus-Levine from the Connecticut Education Association and Rayanne Knopp from the Connecticut Council for Education Reform. Thank you for joining us. This is a big topic. I know there's a lot of stuff in there, and I don't know if we can possibly cover it in this short period of time. But Mary, I want to start with you. I mean, what is the most important thing about this reform that you think needs to come out, and what's the most important thing that you think needs to be changed?
I think the most important thing for us that we were very excited about was the increase in the early childhood slots, the pre-K programs, because we all know that that's a great way to begin to close the achievement gap that everyone so much wants to do. And as far as what needs to come out of the bill, I think that there's probably more really great things than there are things that need to be adjusted. We have some concerns about the charter schools proposal. One of the proposals that remained in the bill still allows charter schools not to service all children. And we would like to see some adjustments made in that area so that all kids have an opportunity. They don't have to win a lottery to get into a charter school, and that they actually would be able to have special ed students, kids who don't speak English, and have the same population that the public schools have.
I think we're all on the same page that we want education to be better, and we all know that Connecticut spends a lot of money per student. Are supporting charter schools necessarily a bad thing? I know the superintendent of the Board of Education feels that we should be supporting more of our traditional schools and not as much emphasis on the charter schools, but yet you go to charter schools and they will tell you they are succeeding and they are doing really well.
Well, you know, I think there's a good way to demonstrate that, and I think supporting charter schools as a part of innovative models for education in our state is an important part of our public education system. But I think we should be supporting all of our schools. And I think one of the most exciting parts about this bill is really helping to intervene in schools and districts that are really struggling to meet the needs of all their students for whatever reason. I would have to agree that I think charter schools should be prepared to serve a broad range of students, not just one population or another. We have a broad range of learners in our state, and they all need the kinds of supports that are necessary to help them be successful.
Kids perform and do well or fail based on many, many different things. Some of that has to do with what they're learning in school and at home. I know from speaking to you in the past and others that you feel that somehow the teachers are kind of taking the brunt of this, that it's up to you to turn things around. Is that unfair, and is that why you did not want teacher certification or tenure to be tied into any kind of reform?
Well, what we really wanted was to decouple from the first bill certification, your license to work, from your employer's evaluation of you. But we've always been for tying evaluation to making employment decisions and getting people to improve their practice. What we also, I think, are feeling is a little, it seems to me that teachers are sort of being isolated in this debate, yet we know that what teachers are on the ground every day. One of the things that's really wonderful about the bill that we advocated for in our View from the Classroom when I last spoke with you, there are what we call wraparound services in the bill. There's opportunities for school health clinics, there's opportunities for more parent involvement, and what we would like to see, and I think that the amendments address this on Monday, we'd like to see a more collaborative approach so it's not, as you describe, all about the teacher.
I think early on the governor really miffed some people when he said, you know, tenure shouldn't be something that should be forever. Do you agree with that, that performance evaluation should be tied into tenure and even certification to some degree?
Well, I think we do agree that evaluation should be tied into how teachers are advanced and promoted and retained, and certainly tenure is a big part of that. How it connects to certification, I think, is a more complicated question. And certainly we want to see the teachers have the supports that they need to improve, and that the evaluation system is used in a way that is responsible and helping teachers to do that. So we certainly feel that's an important part of it.
And I know as far as evaluations, and those are done in many school districts, but they have not been mandatory, and part of this reform requires that they do. There's also another provision that the people who are doing those evaluations changes, and that's parents, and that's also their peers. Is that something that you feel is productive?
We absolutely supported that in the Performance Evaluation Advisory Committee. What we're concerned about is, once a system is developed, because we don't have one yet, we don't have guidelines developed, is all we have is a framework that's been agreed to by the people on that committee. Once that's all put in place, we want to make sure there are safeguards so there isn't abuse. And we advocated strongly for the amendment that teachers have to be evaluated once a year, minimally. And we think that districts who aren't doing that need to be held accountable.
I know many teachers were concerned that they were going to lose their jobs or they were going to get poor evaluations. I understand that there were some talks behind closed doors over the weekend. Do you think that those kind of efforts are going to weaken this bill, and what's going to come out of this is maybe not the best for the students?
Well, I think we're concerned about the fact that that some voices are included in that debate and others are not. And I think that's the responsibility of the legislators and the administration to take into account all perspectives, all stakeholders as they're making these decisions. And it's not that teachers' voices shouldn't be heard, but we think that other voices should be involved in that that discussion as well, including parents. Principals are being held to the same level of evaluation and responsibility and have an important responsibility to learn themselves and to advance themselves and to use the evaluation systems in a way that's effective.
We're running out of time, but I quickly want to ask you, I know the governor had said this week that he thinks when all is said and done that his bill, or the original bill, will be more like that in the end, that whatever happens between now and then, it's going to go back to the way that he wants it. Do you agree with that, or do you think that you can really change his mind? Are you worried about job security for teachers?
Well, what we all want is a fair, more focus on education. I think the governor and other groups all want the same thing. I think that we've made major progress, and I think it's really up to the legislators because it's in their realm right now. And what I see in this bill isn't that the unions block change, but that the legislators actually met with all principals, with superintendents. We know that they were all meeting constantly, just as we were. And the legislators listened to their constituents on the Education Committee particularly and made these amendments to make the bill more responsive to all people's needs, not just, you know, one person's ideas.
I think we need to come back at another time. I know that this is such an important topic. I know the governor has said right from the get-go that he wants this to be a top priority. And I hope you'll come back, and we'll be interested to see what this legislation looks like in the weeks to come.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for joining us.